If we don't do the restoration work that we're doing currently in this landscape, it'll result in more droughts and more drier conditions. We start losing species diversity, we start losing birds and bees and different things that inhabit this beautiful landscape.
In the past 150 years, this landscape has undergone widespread degradation.
Alles is gechanged. Die jaar is 2025. Die weather is gechanged. Levensomstandighede is gechanged.
5 years back was almost like dust. You have these big animals. They need to eat. And then all of a sudden, there's no rain.
It's less sustainable to farm every year. Because the droughts are getting more extreme, so it's just killing the bush here.
Degraded systems, you find that water and nutrients just kind of move through it.
With drought, I've seen farmers reducing their carrying capacities, like their livestock and the farms. Circular type thing. Environment, jobs, people, happiness.
In a search to find ways to restore this degraded land, spec boom emerged as the most efficient tool.
Yeah, but most of the animals, they love spec boom. For example, like kudus and black rhinos, elephant and buffaloes.
I grew up here at Kwandwe. I born here. I remember when I was young on the farm days. The spec boom, they used to eat them. And then they start to have nothing on the base, like nothing. And then they end up like big, almost like a big tree. It's wet now, Kwandwe is looking beautiful now, but not even long ago, it was very dry here. I'm talking like no rain in a couple of months. Like some of the pen, no water, dry.
I'm Johannes Lange. I'm a part-time cattle farmer. I grew up here, was born in 67. But the droughts are getting more and more extreme.
As you can see, the situation here is dire. Animals are dying out in the fog.
We lost about 11 in all.
We open the tap at home, there's no water.
In the early 70s and the 80s, the droughts were typically about two and a half years. But just recently, 2013, we had a drought for almost seven and a half years. And that was extreme.
Was die werkloosheid baie hoog geweest. Baie het by die huis gelê en niks gehad om te doen nie. En omdat hulle niks gehad het om te doen nie.
I'm a thicket ecologist and I've been working the system for over 2 decades. And in the last 10 years I've been focusing very much on restoration. When I started my career as a thicket ecologist, I actually wanted to avoid spec boom because there had already been a lot of research on the species. However, it was really difficult to understand the system as a whole. And it's only when I included spec boom and its role in the ecosystem that things start to make sense. It's because it's the glue that holds the ecosystem together.
Spec boom is a succulent plant or tree that is found across Southern Africa, but it's here in the thickets of the Eastern Cape that it comes into its own and becomes a complete game changer for the ecosystem, increasing the water availability on the landscape, which is incredibly important for this semi-arid region.
So this is a present-day image of intact thicket on a steep slope, and we have a clear fence line contrast and degraded thicket on the other side. If we go and look at the 1940 aerial imagery, we can actually see that intact thicket was also on the other side of the steep slope, but extended down into the flatlands as well, indicating that the degradation was already well established in many of these areas in the 1940s.
Like this is the leaf litter that sits on top. I'm gonna actually do it in stages. When you look through the mulch, you can find different species living onto there, foraging and existing and coexisting. You might find like giant earthworms, frogs, millipedes, spiders. There's a whole ecosystem that goes on into here, like the symbiotic relationship between the soil, the microbial life, the insects, and the plants. When you have a good dense spekboom clumps growing around it, and you've built up that organic content into the soil, it allows for other plants to grow. It sort of increases the water holding capacity. It increases the available nutrients. It improves the microbial life, which also improves the nutrients availability for other plants around the spekboom.
Elephant and black runner, they love spekboom, especially when it's dry. Because when it's dry, some of the plants, they don't have nutrition. They can't keep the moisture in. So that is where they help by the spekboom. We try to plant spekboom in the open overgrazed area, because some of the area they were overgrazed in the farming day, and then end up with no plant. And then when you start to plant this spekboom, and then you start to see under the spekboom, you see a little bit of grass. They're catching up a lot of soil, because if there's no grass, the topsoil is going away. All of those minerals, they go off. Now spekboom, they're stopping that, and then you start to see what is growing around.
At this stage, there's almost nothing to eat here on this side, because we were at about two and a half months of no rain. And on this side, you still see a lot of leaves, nice shoots that the cattle can graze on. There's not a handbook that say this is the way you utilize spekboom. This is totally new. What I do is I started planting quite a few years ago, and I plant a camp and then let it rest a few years. And the moment it's ready and it's strong enough, it's got enough roots so that if cattle or sheep or game come in, that we don't demolish it and we don't pull it out of the soil. So the roots must be strong enough. Nature will tell you, and that's the important thing.
The spekboom is planted by a community around Kwandwe. So those people have no job. And then since they start to this project, planting spekboom, there is a lot of families benefiting and planting the spekboom.
Ek het 'n span van 24 werkers waarmee ek elke dag werk. En die feit dat net carbon en klip laat die projek kom open het, het klip laat weer herlewe gegee. So as meer werkskepping nou in Klippelaat. Jy kan nou sien as lewe in ons dorp. En maand en tye of wanneer daar miskien gepy was, dan sien jy die lewe wat daar weer in ons dorp is.
Spekboom restoration can definitely help improve livelihoods. Like I've seen my guys as well working in the field. I've seen the changes in their lives because I live with them. Like I've seen them starting to build their own houses, like being able to provide better nutrition for their kids. I've seen them being able to support their kids as well, their families. It's quite a trickle-down thing that it does. It's not just the guy that works, but the neighbors as well, the people that stay next to them, yeah.
Only 20% of this amazing ecosystem remains intact. So there's a large degraded area that needs to be restored. And that restoration can't happen passively, it has to be done actively. We need people to go into the landscape and be actively restoring using spekboom. And this is an amazing form of job creation. We have more than 1 million hectares of thicket that needs to be restored. And in this impoverished region, this is a fantastic means of both fixing an ecosystem and solving a social issue.
The restoration efforts that have been put into this area, I think about it in the long-term perspective, like what it does for future generations, because the spekboom restoration thing is not a short-term thing, it's a long-term thing. It'll take a couple of years to see it to what it could potentially be.
To deliver the hope of the people when they come here. Everybody, when they come, they're really hoping to see something. If I achieve that, I feel great.
Ek sien 'n groot verandering. Ek sien nie net die werk as 'n werk nie. Ek sien myself in die toekoms nie hier waar ek my nou sien nie. Ek sien iets goed, ek sien 'n brighter future vir my.
So there's a wide range of people who are coming together to make this restoration a success. From scientists to landowners to investment companies to restoration practitioners to wildlife conservationists and government officials.
This way forward with spekboom is definitely more sustainable than without spekboom. I'm going to continue planting it. I've learned a lot over the last 22 years and I think it's symbiosis.
Now, that makes me feel very hopeful for the future that I want to see in the work that I'm doing. Very proud of the work that we do and the Thicket Restoration.
Thanks so much for watching. For more videos like this, subscribe to the United Nations Environment Programme.